take on the Danbury hat trick. I'm Rob Lopoulos. Thanks so much for joining us here tonight in Binghamton. You're listening to the Endwell Rug pregame show. Endwell Rug, the best floor show in town. Give them a call at 607-748-7366. The Black Bears coming off a weekend sweep, going for win number 3 here on home ice, and a very important couple of games in Binghamton for the Black Bears, is after tomorrow night's home game, they will be on the road away from Binghamton until February 19th, and that is Military Appreciation Night, presented by Lockheed Martin. So Binghamton, and you'll hear Black Bears head coach Rod Davidson talk about how important these next couple of home games are. Tonight, it's the Danbury Hat Tricks back in town, fresh off the overtime loss to the Binghamton Black Bears last weekend. And what a game that was. Let's take you back with the highlights of that one, presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. And the Black Bears, it was a back and forth game. Binghamton in the first period would take the lead, and it was Nikita Ivashkin who would kickstart the scoring for the Black Bears. Some great goaltending as well from Binghamton in net, and it was Ivashkin who got the scoring going to make it 1-0. Colin Fitzgerald into the offensive zone, battles with Easton Oliver. Taking the puck away is Brett Jackson. Now Ivashkin, good cut, left wing circle. Ivashkin, and he scores! Nikita Ivashkin took on about 4 guys and gets the puck into the net. 1-0 Black Bears with 11:02 left. In period number 1, Ivashkin is 35th season. So Binghamton had a 1-0 lead. Danbury would come all the way back to take a 3-2 lead. We advance to the third period. Corey Sherman tied the game at 3.
Jamming away at the loose puck. It's behind the net. Ivashkin still has it. He's hit. Now Newberg to the right point. Powell. Jurich partially blocked. Scores!
The Black Bears tied it up, and then they would have a power play. But Johnny Ruiz had other things in mind.
In and out of the glove of McClendon, and Danbury will send the puck off the glass. They got to hustle back. Emil Strom, Johnny Ruiz, shorthanded. Ruiz scores. Oh, my goodness. A shorthanded goal, and Danbury leads 4-3.
Nikita Ivashkin would tie the game at 4, his second of the night, and then in overtime, Gavin Yates.
35 left to go in overtime, 3-on-3, tied at 4 in Binghamton.
Right at center, stripped away by Gavin Yates. Yates at center, Yates, toe drag, Yates, backhand, he scores! That was probably the most exciting game of the season in my mind. Binghamton, the overtime win. The highlights presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. Visit the Booster Club behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game. We're going to take our first break on the Endwell Rug pregame show. Stick with us, though. When we return, you'll hear from Black Bears head coach Rod Davidson. Back with more right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Let the chase begin.
Join Community Options on Saturday, February 12th at 10 a.m. for the annual Cupid's Chase 5K event held at Otsenango Park. This family-friendly race is great for all ages and benefits people with disabilities. To register, go to cupidschase.org.
Take a trip back to Apartment 4D, home to the crew of the sitcom New Girl for seven incredible seasons. On the Welcome to Our Show podcast, join real-life friends Zooey Deschanel, Hannah Simone, and Lamorne Morris as they rewatch their Emmy-nominated series.
At the end, when he says, "You got some Schmidt on your face," I feel like I pitched that joke.
I believe that.
Whoa. I feel like I did. I'm not 1,000%. I want to say that was, I tossed that one out.
Listen to Welcome to Our Show on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcasts.
After a crash, you have an important decision to make. You can call one of the 100 judge firms, or you can choose William Mattar, the largest motor vehicle accident firm in the state. 607-444-4444, South State Street, Syracuse.
Now back to more of the Endwell Rugg pregame show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Welcome back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Zamboni is off the ice. We're just about set to start the pregame video, and then the guys will take the ice. Puck drop scheduled for about 9 minutes from now. After morning skate today, was able to catch up with Black Bears head coach Rod Davidson.
Coach, maybe one of the most exciting games of the year. Big overtime win for you guys. Just overall, your thoughts on the previous game.
You know, Danbury's such a good hockey team. We had a fairly complete roster that evening, and a star player like Gavin Yates really came through with a dynamic goal in overtime. It was really wonderful to see. The fans had hung in, saw us come back from a deficit and win in overtime, and boy, it was exciting.
Little wild there at the end. You have the power play. You give up a shorthanded goal, but you stayed with it.
Yeah, and we got a couple breaks, as you know. Evashkin comes through again, and then to get to overtime, anything can happen. Three-on-three hockey, you know how exciting that is.
Gavin Yates, though, in overtime, he's got the puck, and I was almost waiting for him to pass it, and then he just goes through all three guys.
It was really spectacular, wasn't it? I mean, it's mesmerizing as a coach standing on the bench wondering what he's going to do. And next thing you know, he makes fabulous moves and then goes in on the goalie one-on-one and made him look poor.
Having Tyler Becker back in the lineup, you could just tell there was a little bit of a boost.
Yeah, Tyler came back, really was happy to be back here. And gave us some jam back on the back end there. And he's a versatile guy, so I think we'll move him up to forward tonight, give him a shot at that.
You get Danbury again tonight. You have Delaware tomorrow. Final two home games, and then you're away until February 19th. How big are these home games?
Huge home games. We have to improve at home anyway. We want a better record in this building. But certainly with what's facing us in the next few weeks, we have to make some hay.
What do you want a little bit differently out of the guys against Danbury? You just saw them.
Watch their star players. You know, Johnny Ruiz, he's always dangerous. He's up the middle of the ice quite often for the stretch pass. He makes it look pretty easy. They've got a complete team. So we've got to be sharp tonight.
All right, Coach. Thanks. Good luck.
Thanks, Rob.
That's Black Bears head coach Rod Davidson. We'll take a timeout on the Endwell Rugg pregame show. When we come back, we'll keep breaking this one down for you. Getting you set for Binghamton-Danbury, the rematch. Back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton.
Breathe easier with Ahanahi. Germicidal UV lights are a safe way to kill viruses and bacteria, destroying over 99.9% of airborne contaminants. Be germ-free. Stay healthy. Find out more. Call Ahanahi today.
Call 722-7234.
After a few weeks on the road, the Binghamton Black Bears return for Military Appreciation Night presented by Lockheed Martin on Saturday, February 19th at 7 p.m. It's a specialty jersey night with proceeds of the jerseys going to charity. Also, all active military and veterans can get a special $5 ticket to the game. Military Appreciation Night presented by Lockheed Martin on February 19th. Visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
Let the chase begin.
Join Community Options on Saturday, February 12th at 10 a.m. for the annual Cupid's Chase 5K event held at Otsenango Park. This family-friendly race is great for all ages and benefits people with disabilities. To register, go to CupidsChase.org.
Now back to more of the Endwell Rug pregame show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Welcome back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. As you hear the intro video playing in the background, the Black Bears hosted a career fair earlier today, and everyone who stopped by and dropped off their resume received a free ticket to tonight's game. And what a great turnout we had at the career fair earlier today. Big thanks to Kelsey Lane up in the office. Just a great job setting up this career fair, and a big shout out to her. It was a great success. Let's get to the scratches and injury update presented by the Court Jester Athletic Club. And we'll start with Danbury. Out of the lineup tonight is Easton Oliver, Gordy Bunnell, Tom and Steve Mealy out of the lineup. Dustin Gesso is suspended. Steve Brown, Zachary Lazaro, Nikolai Lavac, Aaron Atwell all out. And then Tal Finberg on the IR. For the Binghamton Black Bears, out of the lineup tonight, Anthony Merrigan, Thomas Aldworth is injured. He is out tonight. We'll see when he might be able to return. Brandon Contrado out of the lineup. Emil Strom under the weather, non-COVID related. He is out tonight. Cam Yarwood will be out. We'll see when Yarwood might be able to make his Black Bears debut. That is a look at the scratches and injury update presented by the Court Jester Athletic Club, Binghamton's premier fitness facility. Starting lineup brought to you by Visions Federal Credit Union. For the Black Bears on defense, Kyle Powell and MJ Merkel. Up front, Josh Newberg, Nikita Ivashkin, and Gavin Abbott. And Owen Liskowitz going to get the start in net tonight for Binghamton. Starting lineup for Danbury on defense, Garrett Gallagher, Dimitri Daniluk. And up front, Adam O'Asselin, along with Corey Anderson and Dmitry Kuznetsov and Frankie McClendon, will get the start tonight for Danbury. That's a look at the starting lineups presented by Visions Federal Credit Union. Are you a member? Then you get discount Black Bears tickets. Head online to visionsfcu.org/events. That's going to do it for tonight's edition of the Endwell Rug pregame show. Endwell Rug, the best floor show in town. Give them a call, 607-748-7366. When we come back, we'll have tonight's EBE CMS Imaging Solutions opening faceoff. Binghamton and Danbury coming up next on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Tonight's game on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton is brought to you in part by John Paulin State Farm and Well Rug. Excite Motorsports.
Tonight being performed by four students from Marathon School.
And Boys Store. Court Jester Athletic Club. Planet Fitness. Ross Park Zoo. Ideal Bowling Center. EBE CMS Imaging Solutions. Visions Federal Credit Union.
So
Sweets. Now it's time to drop the puck.
Whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we've watched were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting.
It's a 3-3 for the Black Bears tonight here at home against Danbury. Back home tomorrow against Delaware, and then on the road in Delaware on Saturday. Tonight's opening face-off brought to you by EBE CMS Imaging Solutions, the official printer provider of the Binghamton Black Bears. Only game going on tonight in the FPHL. Tomorrow, though, two other games will be taking place. Carolina is in Danbury, so the Hattricks will return home tomorrow night at Danbury Arena, and then Port Huron in Columbus. But this is the only game in the FPHL here tonight. Black Bears in their green jerseys. They will go from right to left. Danbury in the road whites. They will go from left to right. Josh Newberg on the faceoff. He wins it back, and we are underway here in Binghamton. Thanks so much for joining us. The puck rolls in wide of the net. Icing waved off on the breakout pass. Gets by Kuznetsov, and then MJ Merkel fires the puck in deep below the goal line. Gavin Abbott chases, forces Kuznetsov to backhand out to center ice. Kyle Powell pushing Adamo Asselin off the puck. Up the left wing side, Gavin Abbott between the blue lines, backhands behind Nikita Ivashkin, and the Black Bears in their first line change of the night, 40 seconds into the game. No score. Tyler Becker, a forward here tonight. Turnover. Tobias Ogic sends the puck wide. Scooped up by Matthew Wallar. Wallar for Vanderweel. Vanderweel to Gino D'Angelo. Back up top for Wallar. And a stick save made by Frankie McClendon. 18:52 left to go. Period one, no score. Johnny Ruiz winds, fires, and a shoulder save made by Liskowitz. Backhanded by Becker. It hops over the stick of John McDonald. Danny Vanderweel. Vanderweel over to the right side. Becker shooting. And a save made by Frankie McClendon. 18:33 left to go in period one. Best scoring chance of the game so far off the stick of defenseman slash forward Tyler Becker, who's playing up tonight for the Black Bears. Jurich, Sherman, and Gavin Yates on the ice. Yates, the overtime hero last weekend. Fitzgerald and Eric Oganazov at the point. The faceoff in the Black Bears' offensive zone. Right wing circle. Sherman pulls it to his right. Gavin Yates has a lot of pressure on him on that far board. Jurich lost the puck. Played up and out to center ice. And Brendan O'Reilly, who was a late addition, wearing number 11. Gavin Yates was stepped up on, and now it's Brett Jackson to the left wing side. Jackson to Brendan O'Reilly. His shot missed the target. From the point, Garrett Gallagher's attempt goes wide. And the breakout by Jurich is intercepted by O'Reilly. And I thought we might have a penalty there, but play rolls on. As spilling down to the ice was Brett Jackson. Eric Oganazov was on him. Now Colin Fitzgerald behind the net. Wraparound chance. Two left leg pad saves made by Liskowitz. A third. And he finally covers with 17:40 left to go in period number one. No score. Tonight's first period is presented by Cost Cutters. Whatever your style, they've got it. Schedule your appointment today at costcutters.com. 17 minutes, 40 seconds left to go in the opening frame. No score. Defensive zone faceoff. Josh Newberg digging for the puck. It rolls up to Kyle Powell right in front of the Zamboni entrance to our right. He'll elevate to center. Intercepted by Dmitry Daniluk. Daniluk ahead to Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov, low shot. I think it got tipped just wide of the net by MJ Merkel. And now Gavin Abbott with speed. Abbott tripped up, and now we'll get a penalty as Bryce French will go to the box for tripping. And it's a big E-tire power play. 2 minutes and 56 seconds into the game, no score. Black Bears power plays tonight and all season brought to you by Big E Tire. Nobody beats their prices, nobody. Face off in the offensive zone, right wing circle. Vanderweel and Sherman. Powell with Jurich up top. Powell goes all the way back down.
2 minutes for tripping. Time of the penalty, 2:56. That's French, 2 minutes for tripping. Time of the penalty, 2:56.
Gavin Yates at center. Moves in, dodges a big check. Gets the puck in deep. Glove down by Kyle Powell. Powell walks into Jurich. He scores! Kyle Powell walked right in. Dishes it over to Jurich and he buries it. Power play goal. 1-0 Black Bears with 16:39 to go in the first. Great interception. The Black Bears dumped the puck in. They couldn't get to it in time. Powell gloves it down before the puck exited the zone. He stepped up and dished it right over to Jurich, who did not miss. And the Black Bears have a 1-0 lead. Tyler Jurich.
Assisted by number 27, Kyle Powell. Time of the goal, 3:20. That's Jurich from Powell. Time of the goal, 3:20.
So the Black Bears, a 1-0 lead. Tyler Jurich, now Colin Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald dumps the puck back. Has it at the left point. Shot tipped in front of the crease. And now fanning on it was Eric Oganazov. Black Bears got to get back. Kuznetsov, left side, shooting in a right shoulder, saved by Liskowitz. Tough turnover there for the Black Bears, but Liskowitz stays strong in the crease, able to keep that puck out. Now Ivashkin tries to get around the defense. He lost an edge, slides into the corner. Stepping up is Vanderweel. Vanderweel on the left wall. Ivashkin, one touch. Oh, boy. Penalty coming up. And it's a high stick on Vanderweel. That was a great passing play by the Black Bears, though. And Vanderweel heading to the penalty box. And it's now a Trivium Packaging penalty kill. Black Bears penalty kills presented by Trivium Packaging. They are hiring. Apply online at triviumpackaging.com. Oh, yep. I missed that. Did not see Vanderweel. Just lost control of his stick on the check on the left wing side of the ice. And he will sit. Danbury with a chance to respond on the power play. So Binghamton with a 1-0 lead, 15:28 left to go in period number one. And waiting for the penalty time to get put up on the scoreboard as the faceoff will be in the Black Bears defensive zone. That's a double minor as there was blood on the ice. So 4 minute double minor penalty to Dan Vanderweel. Up to the left point, now to the right side. So Vanderweel, 2 minutes or 4 minutes for high sticking, I should say. Up to the left point. Now to the top of the left wing circle. Ruiz, glove save made by Liskowitz, and he hangs on. 17 seconds ticked off the clock. 3:43 left to go. And the double minor. Off the faceoff, the delayed puck drop. It looked like Gavin Abbott. I was surprised that that was dropped. Cross ice pass for Johnny Ruiz. Ruiz scored the big shorthanded goal that eventually forced overtime. In the Black Bears OT win last weekend. 14:46 left to go, period one. 1-0 lead for Binghamton. One touch pass to Ruiz. Backhand, and it's deflected up and into the netting and we'll take our first time out of period number one. 14:37 left to go in the first. Binghamton a 1-0 lead. Back with more right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 14:30 Binghamton. Bears a 1-0 lead. Tyler Jurich the goal. Faceoff is going to be in the Black Bears defensive zone. Left wing dot. Pushed out to center ice. Josh Newberg to the right wing side. Ivashkin. Ivashkin shorthanded. Scores! Season and Binghamton has a 2-0 lead in period one. Josh Newberg got him the puck inside the neutral zone. Ivashkin the cutback and a huge goal.
Scored by number 8, Nikita Ivashkin. Assisted by number 14, Josh Newberg. Time of the goal, 5:32. That's Ivashkin from Newberg. Time of the goal, 5:32.
So Binghamton, a 2-0 lead. Still 2:33 to go. And the Trivium packaging penalty kill. And a big save by Liskowitz with a lot of traffic in front of the net. 2:31 now to go in the Trivium packaging penalty kill. 13:58 left in the first. 2-0 Binghamton. So Nikita Ivashkin. Bottom of the left wing circle. Cycled in below the goal line by Kodiak White Duck. Up to the left point, Garrett Gallagher. Gallagher, left circle, Ruiz. He'll go to the right wing side, John McDonald. McDonald, 5 feet inside the blue line. Saucer pass, deflected, and a left leg pad saved by Owen Liskowitz. Kyle Powell takes over, tries to clear. He can. It's held in by Gallagher. Gallagher, right side, shooting, chest save made, and a quick whistle on the play. Not sure, the strap of Liskowitz's helmet came off, and that was an immediate whistle. With 13 minutes and 22 seconds left to go in period number one. A minute 55 remaining in the Trivium packaging penalty kill. Black Bears with a 2-0 lead. The faceoff is pulled all the way back and goes down the ice. So Binghamton burning some more time off on this penalty kill. A minute 41 to go. Another slap shot and another save by Liskowitz to get a whistle. A minute 39 remaining in the power play for Danbury. So a shorthanded goal. And a power play goal for Binghamton to start things off. Jurich, 3:21 into the game, and then at 5:32, Ivashkin with a shorthanded tally. Into the left wing circle. Back up to the top of the left dot, over to the right side, Daniluk. Daniluk looking, bottom of the left wing circle now. Centered in front, save made by Liskowitz. And the rebound was up in the air and somehow just went wide of the net. Backhand by Corey Anderson. Anderson dishes, he's got a full cage on, does Anderson. Gets the return pass, center point shot, fought off by Liskowitz, but Anderson scores on the rebound. Corey Anderson, his 19th goal of the season, third best on the team. And Danbury splitting Binghamton's lead in half. It's now 2-1, Black Bears with 12:29 left in the first. Black Bears did fantastic on that penalty kill. Liskowitz made some amazing saves, but Anderson finds the back of the net on the rebound. Back into the offensive zone, the hat tricks, trying to tie this game up.
Seven, Corey Anderson, assisted by number 15, Adamo Aslin, and number 4, Dimitri Daniluk. Time of the goal, 7:31. That's Anderson from Aslin and Daniluk. Time of the goal, 7:31.
11:59 left to go in the first. Binghamton had a 2-0 lead. It is now 2-1. The Black Bears being outshot 12-5 as Merkel sends one on net. That's held onto by Frankie McClendon. 11:49 left in period one. Black Bears back home tomorrow night as they welcome in the Delaware Thunder. It's a koozie giveaway presented by Excite Motorsports. First 1,500 fans get a free koozie. It's the final home game for about 3 weeks. For tickets, head to BinghamtonBlackBears.com/tickets. 11:38 to go in the first. Out to the neutral zone, Danny Vanderweel back to Colin Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald over to Eric Oganizov. Back to Fitzgerald, and he will lift the puck out to center. Becker tried to glove it down. Now Oganizov had it knocked by, and Becker with a good hit on the left wing boards. Puck is knocked up to the right point, held in the shot, and it's gloved down by Liskowitz with 11:11 left to go in period one. Ideal Bowling Center is where Binghamton hockey fans bowl, with open bowling all week, along with money-saving specials. Ideal is a great place for family, friends, company parties, and special occasions. Ideal Bowling Center, 119 Jennings Street, Endicott. There's so much more than just your favorite bowling alley. Matthew Boilard, the pass gets behind the defense. Gavin Yates reads it perfectly, and icing is waved off. Good call by the linesman. Jurich is in on the backhand save made on the right shoulder by McClendon. Puck comes up to Kuznetsov, and he backhands off the right wing boards in the neutral zone. Tyler Pekarski lost the puck. Kuznetsov behind the net. Left wing side shot and a shoulder save made. Pass up for Jurich on the breakout. Tyler Jurich to Gavin Yates, and the puck got through Yates. No icing though. John McDonald behind the net. Held in left point by MJ Merkel. Merkel stepped up, covering back for him was Corey Sherman. And then Sherman will get to center ice. His dump in knocked out of the air by John McDonald. And then McDonald looks to connect with Tobias Ogic. Ogic, right side, shot, tip, heads up in the crowd. As that puck went all the way up and over the netting. And everyone seems to be okay. Mad dash for the puck in behind the net. 10:03 left to go in the first. Band in the stands tonight. A little college hockey atmosphere. And the fan has found the game puck. MJ Merkel off the faceoff. Spinorama. Breakout pass to Ivashkin, who is stepped up on by Garrett Gallagher. Ogic trying to hold the puck inside and get it out. Josh Newberg intercepts. Newberg's backhand through the legs and out. Gavin Abbott. Abbott for Newberg. And the puck rolls in below the goal line up to Ogic, but his opportunity was out of the reach at Kodiak White Duck, and now Merkel takes over. MJ Merkel at center, flicks the puck off the boards. Gavin Abbott moves ahead, one hand on the stick, tried to push it out towards the front of the net. Outlet pass to center, Kodiak White Duck lost it. Merkel off the boards to Gavin Abbott, who deflects the puck in deep, and he'll come to the bench for a line change as the puck is covered and held onto with 9:09 left to go in period number one. We'll take a timeout, 2-1 Black Bears. We're back to Binghamton right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Students, every Saturday home game, you can get a $10 ticket. And then take your ticket stub over to Dillinger's after the game for a buy one, get one free drink. That's college students, $10 tickets every Saturday, and a buy one, get one free drink over at Dillinger's. You must be 21. Back underway, 9:03 to go in the first, a 2-1 lead for Binghamton. Jurich and Ivashkin, the goals for Binghamton. Corey Anderson, the goal for Danbury. Snapshot save made by Owen Liskowitz. Big rebound to his left, but the Black Bears were able to get back and clear the damage. Tipped right in. Great feed from the right point. Standing alone on the side of the net was Brett Jackson, his seventh goal of the season. And Danbury has tied the game at two with 8:42 left to go in the first. That was a great look from the right point. And a hat tricks, back-to-back goals. Well, the game is tied at two. Up to the right point, here's Kyle Powell looking for the tip off the stick of Yates in front of the net. Jurich wraps the puck up to the right wing side, 8:15 left to go, period one. Gavin Yates, Yates around one man, around two, trying to go upstairs. Save made by McClendon. Jurich tries again, that might have scraped off the outside of the iron. Powell now from the right point, kept in. Sherman to Powell. He's got Jurich. Powell backhand, missed the net. Cross ice pass. MJ Merkel's got a hustle. Left side and a save made by Liskowitz. And he'll get a whistle with 7:46 left to go in period number one. Hey, Black Bears fans, we are giving away a free Skybox night. All you have to do is text Black Bears to 833-939-3323. And you're entered to win. That's text Black Bears to 833-939-3323. And you could win a Skybox night for you and your friends. 7:29. And a skybox comes with 20 tickets as Colin Fitzgerald is hit hard along the wall. As he was stepped up on inside the neutral zone, gets right back up. So you could win a skybox night for you and 19 other friends. I do not have 19 other friends. Probably think of maybe four people who would want to go with me. 7 minutes to go in the first. The hitting is picking up here in Binghamton. Ivashkin. Puck gets by Gavin Abbott, and Colin Fitzgerald, who seems to be okay after that big hit, will swing the puck up for Gavin Abbott. Abbott trying to catch Danbury in a line change to Tyler Becker. Back in front of the net. Boilard's shot, that is blocked, and now Boilard trying to get back. And this will be an icing as MJ Merkel is back. And the whistle blows. 6 minutes and 32 seconds left to go in period number one. And a 2-2 game. Military Appreciation Night presented by Lockheed Martin coming up February 19th. Black Bears will be wearing special military-themed jerseys, and all active duty and veterans can get a special $5 ticket. For more information, visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com. And we hope to pack that one as the Black Bears will be on the road for about 3 weeks. In Port Huron next Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, and then they have the next weekend completely off as Gino D'Angelo upended. Becker didn't like it. He came in to say hello to Bryce French, who returned it, and then Liskowitz upended as Becker comes in, and now there's a pile of players inside the blue paint. As Pekarski is down inside the net. It was a heavy collision with the goaltender Owen Liskowitz, and then everybody piled into the blue paint. As some pushing and shoving after the play, Garrett Gallagher picks up his helmet. Merkel was in there, Becker. And the officials discussing it down below. MJ Merkel, the only one heading to the penalty box so far after all of that. 6:06 remaining in period one. Pekarski skates back to the bench slowly. Ooh, yeah. So Merkel, the only penalty out of all of that. And Binghamton on the Trivium packaging penalty kill once again. Tied at 2, 6:06 left in the first. Black Bears being outshot 17-8 right now. Face off in the defensive zone, right wing circle, so no penalty on the contact in front of the net, but Merkel picks up two for the rough stuff after the whistle. The shot is gloved down.
Merkel, 2 minutes for roughing, time of the penalty, 13:54. That's Merkel, 2 minutes for roughing, time of the penalty, 13:54.
Face off in the defensive zone. Right wing circle. It's pulled back by Johnny Ruiz. Gavin Abbott, Colin Fitzgerald. Backhand, one-timer, chest save by Liskowitz, and he covers. 5:51 to go in the first, 15 seconds gone in the power play. Ivashkin, Powell, Newberg all come on. Boilard comes off. Pekarski seems to be okay as he is back out there for Binghamton. One back by Newberg behind the net. Kyle Powell rips the puck up the boards and all the way down the ice. A minute 37 to go in the Merkel penalty. 5:40 left in the first. 2-2. Gallagher left side for John McDonald. McDonald ahead to Ogic. Tobias Ogic up to the point. Gallagher skates to his right, passes to the left for Johnny Ruiz. Ruiz tripped, gets right back up, and that's a penalty on Binghamton. From the point, shot tipped up and out of play. .5:12 left to go, and another penalty to Binghamton. It's a 5-on-3. for a minute six. Ivoskin tried to drop his stick, claim his innocence. Didn't work. Face off in the defensive zone, right wing circle. Tough moment here for Binghamton, down a couple of skaters in a tie game. Gallagher, right side. John McDonald, shot and a chest save made by Liskowitz. Kept in by John McDonald. Top of the right wing circle. Over to Garrett Gallagher. Gallagher steps in, shoots, glove save by Liskowitz with 4:50 left to go in the first. We'll take a break. 2-2 the score. 5-on-3 power play continues for the next 44 seconds when we return on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Face off in the defensive zone, right wing circle. Black Bears 2, Danbury hat tricks 2. Rob Lopolis with you inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. 10 feet inside the blue line at the left point. Over to the right side now for Gallagher. 37 to go in the two-man advantage for Danbury. Gallagher over to the left wing circle. That pass was behind Johnny Ruiz, intercepted by Kyle Powell. He couldn't lift the backhand out of the zone. Now a one-timer by Ojic. Big save in front of the net. It's still loose. Battled for on the near side of the ice. Corey Anderson up to Ojic. Ojic looking for Johnny Ruiz. Binghamton trying to clear. They can't. It's deflected and kept in again. 5 to go. Anderson right side. One-timer and a save by Liskowitz, and he covers. Boy, Binghamton, sometimes when you just can't clear it, it just never goes out of the zone. That was the case right there for the Black Bears. But Owen Liskowitz, some big stops. 1 second to go before MJ Merkel comes out of the box. .50 seconds remaining now in the second penalty, so 5-on-4. It's Fitzgerald inside the right wing circle, shorthanded, knocks the puck in down low. And then Fitzgerald took a whack from Bryce French. He backs out to center. Fitzgerald four checks, forces a pass. Corey Anderson taps it to Bryce French. French lost an edge, goes down. Play continues, 23 seconds to go with the Ivoskin penalty. 3.5 remaining in period one. The Black Bears again cannot clear. That shot is blocked by Fitzgerald. Dmitry Daniluk takes back over. Penalty coming to an end in 5 seconds. Ivoskin to his feet. One last chance for Danbury. Gavin Yates, penalty box door opens. Ivoskin is out of the box, and now Kyle Powell moves the puck out through center. Powell over the blue line, around the defense. Powell, chest save made by Frankie McClendon. 2:58 remaining in period one. 2-2 the score. Forced out through center ice is Yates. Evan Yates, left side, shoots, just missed. Had McClendon going to his right. Shot from the right, point by MJ Merkel, and a save made by McClendon with 2:41 remaining in period number one. When the Black Bears win at home, be sure to get your coupon for a free drink over at Red Jug Pub just across the river. Free drink when the Black Bears win at home, courtesy of Red Jug Pub. Hang with us after period one. We'll have the Excite Motorsports first period intermission show coming up once the first 20 minutes is over with. Gavin Yates, his shot is blocked by Garrett Gallagher. Now Gallagher has the puck on the breakout up the right wing side for Ogic. Ogic over the blue line, offensive zone, cuts left, shoots back on net, and a pad save by Liskowitz with 2:20 to go in period one. So stay with us. We'll have the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club highlights, John Pauling State Farm out of town scoreboard, and more. It's the Excite Motorsports first period intermission show coming up following the end of period one. Matthew Boilar up to Gavin Yates. Yates to Sherman. Sherman looks for Jurich. Deflected though. And now Jurich digging for it. Sherman, a nice hit on the far boards. 2 minutes remaining in period one. Powell trying to get back. Powell, good job using the body. And now centered, goes through the shot, and Liskowitz able to get back across to the right side of the crease and make that save. 1:45 now to go in the first. It's Boilar down the right side. Boilar cuts in. Left flank pad save by Frankie McClendon. Gavin Yates, a shot by Newberg, misses the net. Jurich was ducking for cover. Quickly ahead to Josh Newberg. Newberg over the stick of Gavin Yates. And now Newberg has to wait for Jurich to come out of the zone. And we'll have a whistle. Minute 20 to go in period one. Well, as we said, Military Appreciation Night brought to you by Lockheed Martin coming up February 19th. $5 military tickets. That game is not for another 3 weeks, so I hope to see everyone out here for Military Appreciation Night after a brief hiatus from Binghamton. Black Bears hitting the road after tomorrow's home game. Delayed offside, a minute 12 left to go in period one. 2-2 the score. Newberg at center. Offensive zone, the shot missed the net.
1 minute remaining in the period.
Puck rolls in the defensive zone. Colin Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald to Gavin Abbott. Abbott, cross ice, back to Fitzgerald. Ivashkin, now the drop pass. It's Eric Oganazov to the front of the net. Now the Black Bears got to get back. No one was covering at the point. Two on one the other way. Shot, save made, Liskowitz. And he hangs on with 37 seconds remaining in the first. Face off in the defensive zone, right wing circle. Back underway. 32 seconds to go. One timer, and the stick of Ogic goes flying through the air. Tyler Piekarski up to Tyler Jurich. Jurich lifts the puck into the offensive zone. Backhand towards the front of the net. Coming in is Sherman. Wines fires. Block. Sherman again lifts the puck over the crossbar. 10 seconds to go. Big hit by Matthew Boilar. 3 seconds to go. Johnny Ruiz eats the final 10 seconds. And that is it for period number one. Well, the Black Bears had a 2-0 lead. Danbury comes right back to tie it. Binghamton, some key penalty killing in that first frame. And after 20, it's the Danbury hat tricks, too, and the Binghamton Black Bears, too. Shots on net. Danbury, 27 shots on net. 25 saves by Owen Liskowitz in that first period. 11 shots for Binghamton. All even up. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll have tonight's Excite Motorsports first period intermission show on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Your chance to win enter this nationwide.
And standing alone on the set.
That's DeMoss entering FoxSports1430.com.
CMS Imaging Solutions is the official printer provider of the Binghamton Black Bears. For over 40 years, they've been serving businesses around the Southern Tier. Locally owned and operated, EBE CMS Imaging Solutions has a full line of authorized Canon, Sharp, and Kyocera products. With multifunction printers, copiers, and fax machines, they'll help you determine which product is best for your needs, and their staff provides fast and efficient service. EBE CMS Imaging Solutions, 607-723-0000.
Kept in again. Five to go. Anderson, right side. One-timer to save by Liskowitz. Keith Martin on Saturday, February 19th at 7 p.m. It's a specialty jersey night with proceeds of the jerseys going to charity. Also, all active military and veterans can get a special $5 ticket to the game.
Black Bears got to get back.
Presented by Lockheed Martin on February 19th. Visit Binghamton Black Bears.
CryoWorks helps you with cold chills. Just like the ice and black air station, CryoWorks uses freezing temperatures to create a healing process. In listening, cryotherapy helps reduce inflammation, improves muscle tissue recovery, and boosts your immune system. CryoWorks uses three different forms of therapy, whole body, local, and cryofacial. The Black Bears players trust CryoWorks, and so should you. Visit them at 26 South Washington Street, Binghamton, 607-269-5392. CryoWorks, wellness without medicine.
February 12th at 10 a.m. for the annual Cupid's Chase 5K event held at Oxenango Park. This family-friendly race is great for all ages and benefits people with disabilities. To register, go to CupidsChase.org.
The first period is in the books. It's time for the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. A recap of the first period, interviews, highlights, out of time, and more. Back up to the Planet Fitness. Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. Here's Rob
Lapolis. Time for the Excite Motorsports first period intermission show. Excite Motorsports, browse, ride, buy. Free next day delivery to New York and Pennsylvania. Visit them online at ExciteMotorsports.com. Also, speaking of Excite Motorsports, don't forget, pick up your free koozie when you come into the building tomorrow. Brought to you by Excite Motorsports. First 1,500 fans will get one. So get here when the doors open right at 6 p.m. as the Black Bears host the Delaware Thunder tomorrow night at 7 p.m. Take a look at the stat recap from the first 20 minutes of play. Binghamton outshot badly in that first period, 27-11. But Binghamton right now, they had a 2-0 lead in that first period, but Danbury storming back. And that 27 shots, it was a double minor penalty that the Black Bears had to kill off. And then it was a 5-on-3 as well. So just a lot of penalty killing for Binghamton in that opening 20 minutes of play. And that surely had to factor into the 27 shots on net that Danbury pumped between the pipes. But Owen Liskowitz, 25 saves for Binghamton on 27 shots. Tyler Jerich got it going. 3:21 into the game. Power play goal. Kyle Powell, great setup for him. Binghamton a 1-0 lead. Then at 5:32, Nikita Ivashkin, shorthanded goal, assisted by Josh Newberg. 2-0 Binghamton. But Danbury coming right back at 7:31. Corey Anderson, a power play goal from Adamo Asselin and Dimitri Daniluk. 2-1 Binghamton lead, and then Danbury tying it up. Brett Jackson from Bryce French and Brendan O'Reilly at 11:18. 2-2 the score after 20. Four penalties in that first period, three of them to Binghamton. Danny Vanderweel, double minor, high sticking, 4:32 into the game. MJ Merkel roughing at 13:54. That was a scrum after a whistle when Tyler Pekarski was hit hard into the goaltender Owen Liskowitz. Merkel didn't like it. They called it, and he sat for a couple. And then Nikita Ivashkin, a tripping minor right after that. And Binghamton had a fairly lengthy penalty kill on the 5-on-3. It was over a minute, and they were able to keep that puck out of the net. So
Binghamton, 3 penalties for 8 minutes. Danbury, 1 penalty for 2 minutes. That was Bryce French, 2 minutes and 56 seconds into the game. We'll take our first time out here inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. And when we return, we'll cue up the highlights for you presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. Stay with us. Back with more after this on your home for Black Bears Hockey, Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton.
Let the chase begin.
Join Community Options on Saturday, February 12th at 10 a.m. for the annual Cupid's Chase 5K event held at Otsonango Park. This family-friendly race is great for all ages and benefits people with disabilities. To register, go to cupidschase.org.
Get moving today with the Planet Fitness Black Card and check out all the perks, like access to over 2,000 locations, bring a guest anytime, plus massage chairs and so much more. With tons of space in our super clean clubs, your fitness is essential. Get all the perks with the PF Black Card. Commitment may apply. See club for details.
After a few weeks on the road, the Binghamton Black Bears return for Military Appreciation Night presented by Lockheed Martin on Saturday, February 19th at 7 p.m. It's a specialty jersey night with proceeds of the jerseys going to charity. Also, all active military and veterans can get a special $5 ticket to the game. Military Appreciation Night presented by Lockheed Martin on February 19th. Visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
The area's premier fitness facility, Fort Jester Athletic Club, is excited to be open and ready to serve you during your next workout. Join in the new and improved gym experiments with fitness and safety top of mind. Updated cleaning and sanitation procedures will help keep you healthy and ready to keep pushing. Plus, utilize the newly renovated and remodeled equipment and exercise spaces. Reach your goals and escape your limits at Fort Jester Athletic Club, a one-stop fitness experience.
Your area Car Star is a certified iCar Gold Class collision facility. All four locations have earned this industry distinction for consumer safety. Just another reason to trust Car Star, auto body repair experts, and Vestal, Conklin, Owego, and Waverly. Relax, we'll take it from here.
Now back to more of the Excite Motorsports Intermission Show on Fox Sports 1430.
Back inside Vision Veterans Memorial Arena, time for the highlights presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. And it was Tyler Jurich kicking things off early in period one. Interception by Kyle Powell. He walked in and just dished over to Jurich on the left side. Moves in, dodges a big check. Gets the puck in deep. Glove down by Kyle Powell. Powell walks in to Jurich. He scores! With 16:39 to go in the first. So Binghamton, a 1-0 lead. Jurich, big goal there. Power play tally. Then the Black Bears were shorthanded. Didn't matter.
Pushed out to center ice. Josh Newberg to the right wing side. Ivashkin. Ivashkin shorthanded. Scores!
Season, and Binghamton has a 2-0 lead in period one. So Binghamton, a 2-0 lead. It wouldn't last long, though, as Corey Anderson, a power play goal, rebound goal, split the lead in half.
Gets the return pass, center point shot, fought off by Liskowitz, but Anderson scores on the rebound.
Corey Anderson, his 19th goal of the season, third best on the team. And Danbury splitting Binghamton's lead in half. It's now 2-1, Black Bears, with 12:29 left in the first. Binghamton still up by just a goal, but Brett Jackson later in the first tied the game at 2.
Black Bears were able to get back and clear the damage.
Tipped right in. Great feed from the right point. Standing alone on the side of the net was Brett Jackson, his seventh goal of the season. And Danbury has tied the game at two with 8:42 left to go in the first. So Binghamton giving up back-to-back goals, tied up at two. And then the Blackbears needed some help from goaltender Owen Liskowitz. Ruiz, Binghamton trying to clear. They can't. It's deflected and kept in again. Five to go. Anderson, right side. One-timer and a save by Liskowitz, and he covers. Cross ice, back to Fitzgerald. Ivashkin, now the drop pass. It's Eric Oganazov to the front of the net. Now the Black Bears got to get back. No one was covering at the point. Two on one the other way. Shot, save made, Liskowitz. And he hangs on with 37 seconds remaining in the first. So Owen Liskowitz, some big saves at the end of period number one. The highlights brought to you by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. Visit them behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game. We'll take another quick break. When we come back to the Excite Motorsports Intermission Show, we'll have a look at the John Paulin State Farm out-of-town scoreboard. Stick with us. Back with more right after this from Binghamton on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton.
Your area Car Star is a certified iCar Gold Class collision facility. All four locations have earned this industry distinction for consumer safety. Just another reason to trust Car Star, auto body repair experts, and Vestal, Conklin, Owego, and Waverly. Relax. We'll take it from here.
New team, new website. Check out the all-new Binghamton Black Bears website, binghamtonblackbears.com. See all of the Black Bears' upcoming promotions, the latest news on your Black Bears. Check out up-to-the-second standings and stats, and save money with special offers. You can even listen to every broadcast and see what's been happening on their social media. Be sure to follow the Black Bears on social media as well. Stay up-to-date with everything Black Bears at www.binghamtonblackbears.com.
Join thousands of Binghamton hockey fans and give us a follow on social media. Like our Facebook page, facebook.com/BlackBearsFPHL. And give us a follow on Twitter and Instagram at BlackBearsFPHL. Get up to the second team news information, participate in contests, and get live game updates at home or on the road. Get interactive and say hello. Hit that follow button and give the new team some love. That's at BlackBearsFPHL on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
New hockey team in town means all new gear. Dress like the Black Bears and go online to blackbearshop.com. The all-new blackbearshop.com has t-shirts, sweatshirts, hats, jerseys, and so much more. Do you want a custom jersey with your name and number? We can do that too. Stop by the merchandise stand at all Black Bears home games, or even come by the front office during office hours. Show your Binghamton hockey pride by visiting blackbearshop.com.
Ahoney Services is on the job every day. Don't get stuck without hot water. Call Ahoney, and they'll be working on your water heater problem within an hour. Guaranteed. Ahoney Heat quality is what we do.
Call 7227234.
Now back to more of the Excite Motorsports Intermission Show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Welcome back inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Rob Lopolis, as we take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard brought to you by John Paulin State Farm. This is the only game going on in the FPHL tonight. But taking a look at tomorrow's schedule, Binghamton right back at home against the Delaware Thunder. But Danbury will return home tomorrow night out at Danbury Arena. They will host Carolina at 7 o'clock. And then down in Columbus, Georgia, it's the Port Huron Prowlers visiting the Columbus River Dragons. Again, those two games coming up tomorrow night. In the NHL, the Anaheim Ducks with a 3-0 lead over the Montreal Canadiens after one period of play. Sam Carrick, Cam Fowler, Troy Terry, the goals for the Ducks. Hurricanes and Senators, no score after one. Devils, a 1-0 lead in Tampa Bay after 20 minutes. Golden Knights and Panthers knotted up at one apiece. Zach Whitecloud with the goal for Vegas. Barkov, the tally for Florida. Kings leading the Islanders 1-0 after one. Quinton Byfield, the only goal, his first. Kraken and Penguins, no score after one. Rangers and Blue Jackets tied up at two. Artemi Panarin, Barclay Goodrow with the goals for the Rangers. Tonight, Calgary visits St. Louis. The Canucks are in Winnipeg to battle the Jets, Predators at Oilers, and that is a look at everything going on in hockey presented by the Binghamton, or presented by John Paulin State Farm. Visit them online at paulininsurance.com or call 607-798-7191. That's going to do it for the Excite Motorsports first period intermission show. When we come back, we'll drop the puck on period number two, tied at two. Right after this, on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Be the first to get all the latest Binghamton Black Bears news, special exclusive offers, and stay up to date on upcoming games by signing up to join the Binghamton Black Bears email club. Just head to BinghamtonBlackBears.com and sign up today. You'll receive team-related news delivered right to your inbox. Keep an eye out for special exclusive offers only available to email club members. It's the Binghamton Black Bears email club. Sign up and start saving money today.
Get access to exclusive player events, monthly parties, and road trips to away Black Bears games. This is what you get when you become a member of the Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Stop by the Booster Club table behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game, pick up a 50-50 ticket, and sign up to join for just $10. Stay up to date on the Booster Club by liking their Facebook page, facebook.com/Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Monthly meetings with players, road trips, and a whole lot of fun when you join the Black Bears Booster Club.
When a hockey team ends up with six skaters and a goalie on the ice, it means somebody forgot to double check. And when you end up paying more for car insurance than you need to, it can also mean somebody forgot to double check. That's why State Farm will do a free discount double check by going through your policies to make sure you're getting all the discounts you deserve. Because those discounts can mean big league savings. It pays to double check. Call State Farm agent John Paulin in Johnson City today at 607-798-7191.
To more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Back inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena, Rob Lapola set to go period two. As Binghamton tied up at two with Danbury here at home. Black Bears will go left to right. Josh Newberg takes the faceoff for Binghamton. Danbury wins it, and period number two is underway. Ivashkin, Abbott, Newberg up front. Powell with MJ Merkel on the point. Over to Powell. Ahead to Newberg, into the skates of Gavin Abbott. He chases after the puck. Abbott gets to it, tries to cycle below the goal line for Ivashkin. Abbott getting worked over from behind by Dmitry Daniluk, pinned up against the wall. Ivashkin there as well. And out to center ice. Merkel couldn't hold on to the puck, and now he's got to get back. As that's offside now, as Merkel ran into Kuznetsov. And the play is offside. 46 seconds into period number two. In the shots on net in that first period, 27 for Danbury. Icing is called. Becker's thought he touched it, or someone touched it, but to drop the puck at center ice now. So it was a mistake. Defensively, Bryce French Now down the left wing side, Kodiak White Duck. Becker steps up down the right wall. Becker, he's got help in front of the net. That's Gino D'Angelo. He was well defended, though, by Ojic. D'Angelo below the goal line. Johnny Ruiz on him. D'Angelo pinned up against the wall. Ruiz sends it up. Held in left point by Boilard. His shot. And that's tipped just wide. Vanderweel was waiting there. Backhanded by Tyler Pekarski wide. Johnny Ruiz back in behind the net for Bryce French. French looks, goes off the glass, over the glove of Becker. Nope, they'll say he touched it, so no icing. Matthew Boilard. This will be an icing with 18:16 left to go in period number two. Are you looking for a new type of physical therapy? Then give CryoWorks a try. Specializing in cold therapy, your body will start healing in minutes. Visit CryoWorks on Washington Street in Binghamton. Face off in the defensive zone, right wing circle for the Black Bears. Brendan O'Reilly, who was added to the roster, picked up his assist earlier in period one. Corey Sherman intercepted, backhand, save made Liskowitz as he sprawled inside the crease, got a left leg pad on the puck, kept it out. Now another chance, save by Liskowitz as no one was covering in front of the net. Liskowitz, two huge saves with 17 minutes and 46 seconds left to go in the second. Face off in the defensive zone. Left wing circle, 17:46 remaining in period number two. On the face off, it'll be Josh Newberg. Corey Anderson taking the draw across from him. Kuznetsov. Ivashkin kept in by Anderson. He was almost pushed onto his own bench by Newberg. Kyle Powell behind the net. Sneaks the puck over to MJ Merkel, and Merkel will slowly slide it ahead for Gavin Abbott. Abbott, nice move, left circle shooting, lifts it over the crossbar. Kept in by Merkel, left point, nope, he went down to his knees and lost it. Inside the left wing circle, looking for a centering attempt, no one there, and then Merkel comes in with a big hit, scoops up the loose puck, he lost it, and then delivered another hit on Adamo Asselin. On the breakout, Nikita Ivashkin. Ivashkin to the left, right through center ice. Cuts in, upended, tripping penalty coming up. And a big E-tire power play early in period two with the game tied at two. Ivashkin, good move through center ice. And he was tripped up inside the offensive zone. Johnny Ruiz will head to the penalty box with 16:57 left to go in the second period. Face off in the offensive zone, left wing circle. When Merkel lost the puck inside the offensive zone, he was able to get back and laid the body. That helped Ivashkin move away to center ice. Sherman, top of the crease, puck kept in.
3-0-3. That's Ruiz, 2 minutes for kneeing. Time of the penalty, 3-0-3.
So calling kneeing on that, Gavin Yates in, blocked. Yates back up to Powell, over to Juric, back to Powell. Powell lost it. It's a breakaway, shorthanded, 2-on-0, and unable to get the shot away was Kodiak White Duck. He whiffed on it on a 2-on-0. Wow. Binghamton getting a break there as that was a 2-on-0 chance. Offensive zone, left point for Juric. Center point Powell, back to Juric, left side. 4 minutes gone in period two. Vanderweel, left wing circle. Sherman off the end boards, back to Vanderweel. Juric coming over to help out it out. Corey Anderson takes the puck away. Kept in momentarily, but then cleared all the way down. Liskowitz leaves the puck for Yates, back to Powell. Powell, center ice, right side for Jurich, and Jurich lost the puck. Jurich hustles back. Nice play back out to center for Sherman. Sherman over the blue line. He's got Newberg. Finds Yates towards the crease. Yates intercepts. There's a puck on the ice. Someone threw a puck on the ice. Did that come from the stands? Is that a... That is a chuck-a-puck. Come on. Black Bears are pressuring in the offensive zone, and someone threw a chuck-a-puck onto the ice. Well, you just wasted your chuck-a-puck. And you stopped a Black Bear scoring chance, so congrats. 15-12 left to go in the second, 2-2 the score. Ivashkin from his knees wanted a tripping call. Ojic hit hard. Black Bears send the puck up. 2 seconds, one, that's going to do it. Ruiz out of the box. Now Boilard, top of the right wing circle. And the pass, Ojic. Black Bears caught again. Another odd man rush goal. Stepped up for the big hit. That created an odd man rush. Tap in goal. And Danbury leads 3-2. So Binghamton. If you're going to step up and pinch, someone's got to cover. The Black Bears have been caught way too much tonight. An odd man rushes against. 3-2, Danbury.
Ruiz. Assisted by number 96, Tobias Ojic, and number 8, John McDonald. Time of the goal, 5:17.
Well, there you have it. We'll take a break. 14:28 left to go. Second period. The Black Bears scrambling. They trail 3-2. Back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey. Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton. Inside. Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Black Bears trail. 14-18 remaining in the second period. It was a 2-0 lead, and Danbury has scored 3 in a row. Oganazov lifts it up. Missed everything. Kept in by Fitzgerald momentarily at the right point. Newberg covers. Abbott steps up. Puck rolls wide of the net. Oganazov off the end boards for Newberg. Newberg lost the puck. Go ahead. Gavin Abbott. Eric Oganazov scoops it up below the goal line. Oganazov, good move. Finds Newberg. Newberg to Gavin Abbott. Abbott back to Newberg. Wrister, save made by McClendon. Kuznetsov picks up the puck. Little toe drag, gets some space. And Kuznetsov backhands in deep. Eric Oganazov up the left point. Gavin Abbott can't get the puck out of the zone. Eric Oganazov back to Colin Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald for Abbott. Abbott goes off the glass into the offensive zone. Oganazov steps up, bottom of the left wing circle. Eric Oganizov to Nikita Ivashkin. Ivashkin behind the net. Wrap around, still free, top of the crease, and held on to with 12:57 left to go in period two. See where they drop this one. 12 minutes, 57 seconds. Remaining in the second period, we're live inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Now a chance. Kodiak White Duck drops it back, scores. Four in a row for Dan Barry. And they lead 4-2 at 12:46 to go in the second. So another goal for Danbury, four in a row, and they have pumped 30 shots on net, and we're not even midway through this game.
Number 14, Kodiak White Duck. Time of the goal, 7:14. That's Ajik from White Duck. Time of the goal, 7:14.
You'd like a chance to win a Black Bears
face off in the offensive zone. Well, the Black Bears got to pull it together. Too much stepping up has created numerous odd man rushes against. They got to start shutting it down. Yates shoots, sticked into the corner by Frankie McClendon. 12:23 left to go in the second. 4-2 lead for Danbury. Jurich down the right wing side. And we said it before, it's not just the defense stepping up. Defense can step up, but someone has got to realize that that is happening and then cover back. That is where the mistake is coming from. 12:02 left to go, second period, 4-2 lead. Defensively flicked up in the air by Dmitry Daniluk, Colin Fitzgerald. Out of the neutral zone. And then O'Reilly. And offside is called with 11 minutes and 48 seconds to go in period two. The Black Bears have live online auctions happening all season. Head to BinghamtonBlackBears.com, click live online auctions, or download the Live Source mobile app on your device. Keep checking back all season for new Black Bears live auctions at BinghamtonBlackBears.com. 11:39 to go in the second period. 30-15, the shots favor Danbury. Backhanded towards the front of the net. Knocked down by Pekarski. Bottom of the right wing circle. It's still loose at the top of the crease. They can't get it out. Blast and a glove saved by Liskowitz with 11:20 to go in the second. Binghamton will change. MJ Merkel comes on defensively with Kyle Powell. Becker, Vanderweel, and Gino D'Angelo up front. Corey Anderson taking the faceoff for Danbury. Wins it back, but it goes right under the stick of John McDonald. And Vanderweel lost it out of the stick of Adamo Asselin. And now through the skates, Becker off the boards to himself. And it's cleared away by the goaltender, Frankie McClendon. There's a broken stick just below the goal line. Becker behind the net. He was hit. gets the puck back, tries to center, goes up to Powell. Powell lost an edge, and Anderson is hit hard, and he's a big guy. MJ Merkel stepped up at center ice. 10:35 left to go in the second. A 4-2 lead for Danbury. Gavin Yates takes the puck, finds Vanderweel. Vanderweel cuts in, misses the net. What a move by Vanderweel. Right back to center. It's Jurich. Jurich down the left side, drops it back, right back for Merkel. And the puck rolls on him, and he fans on the shot. Binghamton needing a bounce here. Up to MJ Merkel. Off his shin guards, Gallagher. Gallagher behind the net. It's Kyle Powell at the left point. Saves the day, keeps the puck inside the zone. Good shift by Binghamton. Jurich to Powell. Powell center blue, couldn't get the puck off the ice. It's loose. A shot by Gavin Yates. Now to MJ Merkel, tipped just wide. Jurich, shot by Sherman. He missed, and the puck goes all the way down the ice. Black Bears got to get back. Bad pass, intercepted by Kyle Powell. Quick transition, Jurich, left side, in front, drop pass, Sherman. Who is throwing pucks on the ice? Gotta get that guy out of here. My goodness. Grow up. 9:17 to go in the second. We'll take a break. 4-2 Danbury. Back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey. Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton. To go in the second period. Bates off in the Black Bears defensive zone right wing circle. Bates off in the defensive zone right dot. 4-2 lead for Danbury. Johnny Ruiz on MJ Merkel. Now Kyle Powell centered. Blocker pad saved by Liskowitz. 9:03 to go in the second. A 4-2 lead for the Danbury Hat Tricks. And the only two goals of the period. Ivashkin left side to Newberg. Newberg, wrister right up in the air. Glove down, and then the puck below the goal line. Now they'll call a hand pass with 8:48 to go in the second. I think the faceoff will come outside the zone now. In front of the Black Bears bench. Jeez. Puck is won back to Dmitry Daniluk. Now ahead onto the stick of Brendan O'Reilly. O'Reilly, the puck goes straight up in the air and lands just to the right of the crease. Colin Fitzgerald intercepts. He's got Gavin Abbott with him. Fitzgerald behind the net for Ivashkin. Top of the crease. Puck got through everyone. 8:20 to go in the second. And a 4-2 lead for the Danbury hat tricks. Colin Fitzgerald goes cross ice. Gloved out of the air by Abbott. Abbott has Ivashkin trailing. Abbott below the goal line right through the crease. Ivashkin couldn't get there in time. Trailing on the breakout, Brett Jackson. He's got a goal tonight. Jackson, left circle, in below the goal line, looking for something. Kuznetsov with a one-timer and a right leg pad save by Liskowitz. It is all Danbury right now with 7:44 left to go in the second. You hear the linesman yelling delayed offside in the background. That gives Newberg a chance to get out to the neutral zone. 7.5 remaining in the second frame here live in Binghamton. It was 2-2 after one. Danbury back-to-back goals here in the second. They lead 4-2. Shots here 34-18. Vanderweel going to the net. And upended is Becker. Becker on the back check. Gets back into the neutral zone. Kyle Powell lifts the puck up and in. D'Angelo on the forecheck. Powell, Vanderweel, a big hit all the way down the ice. MJ Merkel picks up the puck behind the net and flubs one out to center. That's going to be an icing with 6:47 left to go in period two. Our next broadcast tomorrow at home, right back here against Delaware. If you can't make it, tune in beginning at 6:45. Endwell Rug pregame show. Puck drops at 7. Binghamton and Delaware tomorrow night from Visions Veterans Memorial Arena on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton. 6:42 to go in the second. Black Bears down by a pair. Merkel behind the net. Up to Gino D'Angelo. Daniluk grabs a puck out of the air. And then Merkel took it away from D'Angelo, who's back in behind the net. They both go down to the ice. Good pass up to Gino D'Angelo. Gino caught up to, lost the puck. Ogic hit by MJ Merkel. Vanderweel, and the puck is covered up by Liskowitz, and a whistle with 5:59 left to go in the second. Looks like Ogic wants a penalty. It was hard to see on the near side wall. He got tangled up with MJ Merkel. 5:59 remaining in the second. Looking for a night out with friends or family? Check out our great group offers with tickets starting as low as $8. The Black Bears have sky boxes available as well with an updated food and drink menu. Set up your group night. Call 607-722-7367. Jurich cross ice pass knocks the stick right out of the hands of John McDonald. 5:42 to go in the second period. Binghamton needing a couple of goals. O'Reilly shot, saved by Liskowitz. Heavy collision and going down to the ice. Binghamton right back into the offensive zone. That's Brett Jackson who was injured and gets back to the bench slowly. Sherman gets the shot on net as he was falling down to the ice, covered up and held onto by McClendon with 5:20 to go in period two. The Learning Ladder Child Care Center is located in Endicott in Johnson City. Enroll children ages 6 weeks to 12 years old. Call 607-770-3806 for an appointment today to walk through one of their facilities. Come join their family, and they will help your child grow. Offensive zone faceoff. It's Jurich, Yates, and Sherman up front. Back at the point, Colin Fitzgerald with Eric Oganazov. Anderson, a lot of heavy pressure, turned over Kuznetsov, and then he coughed it up. Kuznetsov had some time. He didn't think he had that much time. Jurich, nice pass over to Oganazov. Oganazov, spinorama, dishes down to Sherman. Shot off the side of the net. Sherman waiting in front of the net as Yates lost an edge below the goal line. Jurich now on the left wing wall. Nice pass up top. Colin Fitzgerald shooting. No one in front of the net. Easy glove save for McClendon, and we'll take a break. 4 minutes and 30 seconds left to go in the second period. Danbury 4, Binghamton 2. Back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey. Fox Sports 1430, Binghamton. Off the face-off in the offensive zone. Cross-ice pass out to center. Ogic, odd man rush, shot, big save. Ooh, that's a big collision. Ogic slides hard into the boards. Now Ivashkin, hip check, upended. He's down on the ice, and he's not getting up. And the Black Bears looking around, waiting for something, and now the Black Bears are going to get a penalty from the bench. How about that? Ivashkin still down on the ice. And now the referee's upset with something the Black Bears said, and someone will pay for it. Ivashkin still down on the ice. We'll get a replay probably shortly with, it's hard to tell, Black Bears not happy about it. Ogic was hit by Merkel. He went into the boards. Down to our left. It was a hard collision. Back first. And hope he's okay. And then at the other end of the ice, Nikita Ivashkin. And he's going to just skate right to the locker room. So Ivashkin hurt on the play, but the penalty is against Binghamton with 4:01 to go in the second. How is that not a knee? That was right into the right kneecap of Ivashkin, and he is down and out of the game. I mean, I don't know how that is not a penalty, but instead the Black Bears will sit in the box. To go in the second, and it is somehow a trivia packaging penalty kill. Face off in the Black Bears defensive zone left wing circle. The best player in the league injured out of the game. Newberg on the faceoff. It's one back. We'll wait for this call.
Binghamton penalty to number 12, Gavin Yates. 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. Time of the penalty, 15:59. That's Yates. 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. Time of the penalty, 15:59.
All right. Fitzgerald tries to get the puck out of the zone. It's a broken stick. Let's see who that belongs to. It belongs to Josh Newberg. Newberg without a stick. Ojek. Now Fitzgerald trying to get back into the play. Now there's a loose glove on the ice as well. That belongs, and that's picked up by Kodiak White. Johnny Ruiz inside the right wing circle. Goes all the way around. And then up top for Gallagher. Gallagher to Ruiz. Just below the goal line. Merkel comes away with the puck. Tries to get it out of the zone. Could not. Tobias Ojek hit by Merkel, and now Colin Fitzgerald shorthanded. And he will dump the puck all the way down the ice. 52 seconds to go in the Gavin Yates penalty for an unsportsmanlike conduct. Came from the bench. 2:43 to go in the second. Up to the left point, Daniluk. And a good clear by Tyler Pekarski. 30 seconds to go in the Binghamton penalty. 2:27 to go in the second. Sherman ahead on Adamo Asselin. And Kyle Powell sends the puck down. 10 seconds left. Gavin Yates to his feet. Frankie McClendon banging the stick on the ice. Penalty box door opens. Yates is free. Back to 5-on-5. Under 2 minutes to go. Shot. Save made. Big rebound. Gathered again by Danbury. Kuznetsov's shot blocked by Boilard. And now ahead for Yates. Yates right side. Pinched off the puck. Intercepted by Sherman behind the net. Ojek hits him. Puck comes up to the left point. Pekarski. Back for Juric below the goal line, and now Danbury tries the near side of the ice, and the puck goes all the way down. 1:26 to go, second period, turnover, Ojek in, save made by Liskowitz. Backhand, top of the crease, Matthew Boilard below the goal line. They can't connect up the left wing side, held in at the right point. Gavin Yates below the goal line. Yates off the boards, up top for Sherman with 1 minute to go in the second. A 4-2 lead for Danbury after being hit in the knee. Ivashkin is out of the game right now. We'll keep an eye on that. Tyler Juric below the goal line. And Merkel steps up at the point. Becker covering back. Pass by Merkel to Powell. Linesman not getting out of the way. Finally does, and Powell shakes free from the pressure. Lost the puck, though. 23 seconds to go in the second. Binghamton held off the scoreboard in period two. They are being outshot 38-19. 8 shots for Binghamton in this period. Guys, who is throwing... Someone has got to be thrown out of this game. Where are the chuck-a-pucks coming from? My goodness. That is it. Someone point them out. I can't see it. Like, literally blows my mind. That is it for 2 periods of play. It is a 4-2 lead for Danbury. And when we come back, we're going to kick off the Excite Motorsports second period intermission show. With 1 period to play, it's Danbury 4, Binghamton 2. Back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Moron.
Listen every hour from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. weekdays for your chance to win $1,000.
Short-handed 2-on-0 and unable...
Ahanahi Services, keeping homes and businesses comfortable since 1906. Ahanahi Services, trusted by your friends and neighbors. Call 722-7234. Your next chance to win $1,000 is coming up on Fox Sports 1430.
Get moving today with the Planet Fitness Black
Skull. Wallar stepped up for the big hit. That created an odd man rush. Tap in goal. And Danbury leads 3-2.
Super Clean Clubs. Your fitness is essential. Get all the perks with the PF Black Card. Commitment may apply. See club for details.
The Ross Park Zoo sits tucked into the northern face of Binghamton's South Mountain. The zoo officially opened in 1875 and is the fifth oldest zoo in the country. Come view over 100 different species. Are you planning your next event? Train rides, the children's zoo, Ross Park Carousel, Snack Shack, Gift Shop, and special education stations are just some of the reasons why Ross Park Zoo should be your next event. You can even set up wild encounters. Give Ross Park Zoo a call at 607-724-5461.
An odd man rush, tap in goal. And Danbury leads 3-2.
Of Binghamton's South Mountain. The zoo officially opened in 1875 and is the fifth oldest zoo in the country. Come view over 100 different species. Are you planning your next event? Train rides, the children's zoo, Ross Park Carousel, Snack Shack, Gift Shop, and special education stations are just some of the reasons why Ross Park Zoo should be your next event. You can even set up wild encounters. Give Ross Park Zoo a call at 607-724-5461 or online at rossparkzoo.org.
Two periods are complete. It's time for the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. A recap of the first two periods, interviews, highlights, out-of-town scores, and more. Back up to the Planet Fitness broadcast booth for the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report.
Welcome back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena after 40 minutes of play. It is Binghamton trailing the Danbury Hattricks 4-2. Time for the Excite Motorsports second period intermission show. Excite Motorsports. Browse, ride, buy, free next day delivery to New York and PA. Visit them online at excitemotorsports.com. We'll take a look at that stat recap from period number two. The Black Bears right now being outshot, as I said, 38-19. Eight shots for Binghamton. In that second period of play, they had 11 in the first, 8 in the second. Danbury, 27 shots in the first and 11 in the second. Binghamton surrendering two goals in period two, 5:17 into the second. It was Johnny Ruiz from Tobias Ojic and John McDonald. That gave Danbury the 3-2 lead. And then Ojic strikes from Kodiak White Duck at 7:14. And it is a 4-2 Danbury lead. Binghamton led 2-0, and Danbury has scored the last four. In period number two, two penalties were called. Johnny Ruiz, kneeing penalty at 3:03. And then Gavin Yates, it was an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. Not sure if that was a bench minor and then it was just served by him, but I think it was Yates who said something, and the referee did not like it one bit and put him in the penalty box while Nikita Ivashkin laid down on the ice after taking a knee shot inside the offensive zone. So Binghamton able to kill that one away. So just two penalties in period two, one to either side. Binghamton right now with four penalties in the game. Four penalties for 10 minutes. It was a double minor penalty to Danny Vanderweel back in period one. Danbury, two penalties for 4 minutes in this one. So in net, Owen Liskowitz has stopped 34 shots through two periods of play. And Frankie McClendon has stopped 17 of 19 at the other end of the ice. We'll take our first time out. When we return, we'll cue up the highlights presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Now's your chance to win $1,000.
Unbelievable.
Just enter this nationwide keyword on our website, Word. That's Word. Enter at FoxSports1430.com.
Check out a Binghamton Black Bears game like you've never seen before for the Skybox Night or Group Night. You can even watch warm-ups from the Black Bears bench with your friends, high-five the players as they take the ice, and so much more. Or watch the game in style in a Skybox and check out a new and improved food and drink menu. Call the Black Bears at 607-722-7367 and begin your group or Skybox experience.
Ideal Bowling Center, located at 119 Jennings Street in Endicott, has 38 amazing lanes of bowling, large video screens, and automatic scoring. But that's not all. Ideal Bowling Center has a newly remodeled bar with 6 televisions, billiards, darts, and quick draw to entertain you. Don't forget about Ideal Bowling Center's snack counter for your appetite and a pro shop for all your bowling needs. Ideal Bowling Center, 119 Jennings Street in Endicott, or call 607-748-3546.
Trivium Packaging, a global leader in sustainable metal packaging with more than 60 locations worldwide, has immediate openings at its Conklin, New York facility. Trivium serves a diverse range of customers and is an essential part of the U.S. food supply chain. Trivium Packaging offers excellent compensation and benefits like these. Apply anytime at triviumpackaging.com/careers or scan the QR code on the screen. Trivium Packaging currently has openings for tool and die technician and shipping and receiving technician.
Black Bears hockey is back tonight and tomorrow. Tonight, career fair night from 3 to 5:30. Free tickets.
Hey, the
game when you attend. Then tomorrow, Black Bears koozie giveaway. Courtesy.
This shouldn't be playing. This is a 15-second.
Now back to more of the Excite Motorsports Intermission Show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Back inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. About 10 minutes until we drop the puck on period number 3. Time for the highlights brought to you by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. Go all the way back to period number 1. And it was Tyler Jurich getting things going. Moves in, dodges a big check. Gets the puck in deep. Glove down by Kyle Powell. Powell walks in and Jurich, he scores! With 16:39 to go in the first. Binghamton 1-0 lead, and then Nikita Ivashkin, who is injured and has not returned. We'll see if he comes out for the third period. Shorthanded goal to give Binghamton a 2-0 lead. Pushed out to center ice. Josh Newberg to the right wing side. Ivashkin. Ivashkin shorthanded, scores! And Binghamton has a 2-0 lead in period 1. So Binghamton a 2-0 lead, but then Danbury the comeback. Gets the return pass, center point shot, fought off by Liskowitz, but Anderson scores on the rebound. Corey Anderson, his 19th goal of the season, third best on the team. And Danbury splitting Binghamton's lead in half. It's now 2-1, Black Bears, with 12:29 left in the first. Binghamton then up 2-1, and then Brett Jackson tied the game. Black Bears were able to get back and clear the damage. Tipped right in. Great feed from the right point. And standing alone on the side of the net was Brett Jackson, his 7th goal of the season. And Danbury has tied the game at 2 with 8:42 left to go in the third. Binghamton all tied up at 2 at that point of period 1. And then Owen Liskowitz needed at the end of the first. Ruiz, Binghamton trying to clear. They can't. It's deflected and kept in again. 5 to go. Anderson, right side. One-timer and a save by Liskowitz, and he covers. Cross ice, back to Fitzgerald. Ivashkin, now the drop pass. It's Eric Oganezov to the front of the net. Now the Black Bears got to get back. No one was covering at the point. Two on one the other way. Shot. Save made. Leskowitz. And he hangs on with 37 seconds remaining in the first. So Binghamton 2, Danbury 2 after 1. We go to the second. Danbury a 2 on none. And they couldn't get the shot away. Up to Powell. Over to Jurich. Back to Powell. Powell lost it. It's a breakaway. Shorthanded. 2 on 0. And unable to get the shot away was Kodiak White Duck. He whiffed on it on a 2 on 0. So, didn't hurt him though, as Johnny Ruiz gave Danbury the lead. And the pass, OJ. Black Bears caught again. Another odd man rush goal. Stepped up for the big hit. That created an odd man rush. Tap in goal. And Danbury leads 3-2. And they would add another one at the towards the end of, or a little bit after that, actually. And it's Danbury 4 and Binghamton 2. The highlights presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. Visit them behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game. We'll take a break. John Paulin, State Farm Out of Town Scoreboard, coming your way next on your home for Black Bears Hockey, Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton.
Getting your hands on an all-new...
Yeah, sorry about that. The break started with a 15-second spot, and it ended with a 15-second spot.
Oh, okay.
Spot.
No, that was weird. I was like, it's a little... This is a short one.
I think it's been set up a couple times that way tonight so far.
Okay.
Get approved for financing and e-sign online right from your phone. Ride. Have your new power sport vehicle delivered to your home the next day at no extra charge. Browse, buy, ride. Fun starts here at Excite Motorsports.
EBE CMS Imaging Solutions is the official printer provider of the Binghamton Black Bears. For over 40 years, they've been serving businesses around the Southern Tier. Locally owned and operated, EBE CMS Imaging Solutions has a full line of authorized Canon, Sharp, and Kyocera products. With multifunction printers, copiers, and fax machines, they'll help you determine which product is best for your needs, and their staff provides fast and efficient service. EBE CMS Imaging Solutions. 607-723-0000.
Are you looking to get your hands on game-worn autographed jerseys? You're in luck. Black Bears fans can now bid live online for game-worn jerseys. Just head to BinghamtonBlackBears.com and click Live Online Auctions on the homepage. You can even download the Live Source mobile app on any device, so you never miss a chance to place a bid. Live Online Auctions are going on now. Download the Live Source mobile app or visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
CryoWorks helps you with cold therapy. Just like the ice the Black Bears skate on, CryoWorks uses freezing temperatures to create a healing process. In just minutes, cryotherapy helps reduce inflammation, improves muscle tissue recovery, and boosts your immune system. CryoWorks uses three different forms of therapy, whole body, local, and cryofacials. The Black Bears players trust CryoWorks, and so should you. Visit them at 26 South Washington Street, Binghamton, 607-269-5392. CryoWorks, wellness without medicine.
Now back to more of the Excite Motorsports Intermission Show on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Back inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena, continuing the Excite Motorsports second period intermission report. No other games going on in the FPHL tonight, but tomorrow the Black Bears, of course, right back at home here against Delaware. Carolina is in Danbury tomorrow. And also tomorrow, Columbus hosting Port Huron in the National Hockey League. The New Jersey Devils had a lead over Tampa Bay. And last we checked, Tampa Bay has come back to take a 2-1 lead over the Devils. And of course, the page freezes right as the scores are trying to load. Finally, we got it. Anaheim Ducks 5-2 lead in Montreal after two periods of play. Hurricanes and Senators tied at 1 after 40. Tampa Bay a 2-1 lead over the New Jersey Devils. Killorn, Matthew Joseph, the goals. power play goal and shorty for Joseph in period two. Panthers leading the Golden Knights 2-1 after two. Kings 2-0 lead against the Islanders. Kraken and Penguins no score, but the Penguins out shooting the Kraken 20-9. Columbus Blue Jackets have built a 4-2 lead over the New York Rangers, and the St. Louis Blues have a 2-1 lead over the Flames. Canucks and Jets tied at one, and getting underway in about 10 minutes, the Predators visit the Oilers. That is a look at the out-of-town scoreboard presented by John Paul and State Farm, and we'll take our final break. When we come back, we'll drop the puck on period three. The Black Bears need a couple. Can they do it? We'll find out right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton.
The area's premier fitness facility, Port Jester Athletic Club, is excited to be open and ready to serve you during your next workout. Join in the new and improved gym experience with fitness and safety top of mind. Updated cleaning and sanitation procedures will help keep you healthy and ready to keep pushing. Plus, utilize the newly renovated and remodeled equipment and exercise spaces. Reach your goals and escape your limits at Port Jester Athletic Club, a one-stop fitness experience.
New team, new website. Check out the all-new Binghamton Black Bears website, binghamtonblackbears.com. See all of the Black Bears' upcoming promotions, the latest news on your Black Bears. Check out up-to-the-second standings and stats, and save money with special offers. You can even listen to every broadcast and see what's been happening on their social media. Be sure to follow the Black Bears on social media as well. Stay up to date with everything Black Bears at www.binghamtonblackbears.com.
Thousands of Binghamton hockey fans, and give us a follow on social media. Like our Facebook page, facebook.com/BlackBearsFPHL. And give us a follow on Twitter and Instagram at BlackBearsFPHL. Get up to the second team news information, participate in contests, and get live game updates at home or on the road. Get interactive and say hello. Hit that follow button and give the new team some love. That's at BlackBearsFPHL on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
Rolando's Diner is now open. Rolando's Diner, a 50-year tradition in Binghamton, is now open. They are still located in the same place, 140 Court Street, and they still have the same great menu and same great prices. Daily and weekly specials available. They missed you and can't wait to see all of their happy customers again. Rolando's Diner, eat in or take out. Open 7 a.m. until 3 p.m. daily. Call 607-723-9058 for takeout. See you soon.
Now back to more Black Bears hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Set to go, period three. Welcome back inside the Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Nikita Ivashkin back out skating around a bit, so he seems to be okay enough to play through it here for the final 20 minutes of action. Black Bears will go right to left. The Danbury hat tricks will go left to right. Josh Newberg for Binghamton. Corey Anderson for Danbury. Anderson wins the faceoff, but Newberg gets it right back. Low shot and a blocker pad save. Gavin Abbott down low for Nikita Ivashkin. Ivashkin wraps it around. Had Newberg in front of the net. Stopped. Now the trailer, Kuznetsov, or check that, the trailer, Corey Anderson missed high. Slap shot goes by the face of Newberg, and now Powell to center. Ivashkin into the offensive zone, shooting, and the stick goes on top of the net as Ivashkin goes crashing into the end boards. And he will skate slowly back to the bench. Pass by MJ Merkel, intercepted. Ojek shot, Merkel partially blocked wide and then held on to by Liskowitz, 48 seconds into period three. Face off in the defensive zone, left wing circle coming up. Rob Lapolis live inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Matthew Boilard behind the net. Boilard, good pass to Gino D'Angelo. D'Angelo to center ice. Down the left wall, Vanderweel. Vanderweel pinned up against the boards. Digging for the puck is Gino. rolls up to Boivin. His shot partially tipped wide. Pekarski was pinching to the left. And now he's got to go all the way back down the ice. Waiting below the goal line, Tyler Becker. Left side, Wallar back for Becker. And now Pekarski has it. Pekarski floats one up to center. No one there, intercepted. And Binghamton has to try again on the breakout. Wallar back to Pekarski. Pekarski up the left wing wall. Gallagher. Vanderweel lost it. Little two on one from the hash mark. Save made. Liskowitz run into and the puck is in. Now that's it. 5-2 with 18:11 to go in the third. Danbury tonight. Head coach Rod Davidson expressed the importance of these final two home games before the Black Bears hit the road for an extended period of time. Off coming up.
Scored by number 11, Brendan O'Reilly. Assisted by number 16, Michael Lopez. And number 18, Brett Jackson. Time of the goal, 1:49.
I believe that is O'Reilly's first pro goal. So congratulations to him and a three-goal lead for Danbury. Bottom of the right wing circle. Colin Fitzgerald chasing back with Eric Oganizov, and icing is called with 17:52 to go in period three. Join the Black Bears Kids Club today for just $10. You get a Kids Club t-shirt, gifts courtesy of New York's 529 College Savings Program, Texas Roadhouse in Midway Lanes. Also free Black Bears tickets and a post-game skate. Sign up on the concourse between sections 10 and 11. Kuznetsov, what a save by Liskowitz. Black Bears caught again, little odd man rush. Powell was trying to get back, and Liskowitz a nice save. Frankie McClendon plays the puck up. Swung back to Johnny Ruiz. Ruiz, right leg pad save Liskowitz, and he pulls the puck into his glove for a whistle with 17:28 to go in the third. Speaking of third, the third period brought to you by American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning. Don't settle for less. Ask American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning, built to a higher standard. Back underway. 17:18 to go, third period. The Black Bears need three. Jurich fires the puck all the way down the ice, but he had crossed center ice. No icing. Interception. Yates still with it. Can't get the shot away. Stepping up is Pekarski. Pekarski right on the goal line. Jurich side of the net. The puck rolled on him. And a hit as Daniluk takes down Gavin Yates, but Yates stepped into him and forced the puck loose. And now he'll go to the bench for a line change. Turnover, Jurich. Jurich to Gavin Abbott. Abbott a shot and a blocker pad save made by Frankie McClendon. Ballard's shot off of Sherman in front of the net. Matthew Ballard, backhand, scores! Bears. The end boards, Eric Oganazov. Colin Fitzgerald up to Gavin Abbott. Abbott fires it in, saved by McClendon. He hangs on, offensive zone faceoff coming up.
21, Corey Sherman. Assisted by number 22, Tyler Jurich. And number 43, Matthew Waller. Time to go, 3:35.
The Black Bears down by a couple, plenty of time left here in the third period. Good move at center ice. Now Gavin Abbott ahead for Nikita Ivashkin and ripped up the far side of the ice. So Binghamton. Goal here in the third. Each team with a goal in the third. 15:27 left to go. In regulation, Ivashkin, Newberg, and Abbott. And the puck goes up and out of play. And a whistle. 15:19 left in period three. Military Appreciation Night presented by Lockheed Martin, February 19th. That is the next home game after tomorrow night. Military-themed jerseys and all active duty military and veterans can get a special $5 ticket. All you got to do is visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com. Good pass and a great chance. Great save by Liskowitz with 15:04 to go in the third. Said the Black Bears final game before Military Appreciation is tomorrow. It's an Excite Motorsports koozie giveaway. Black Bears logo on that koozie as well. First 1,500 fans, so be sure to get here when the doors open at 6 as Corey Anderson denied with the left leg pad of Owen Liskowitz. Gavin Yates, good shake into the offensive zone. He dodged the check and then caught one up high by Anderson. Anderson's helmet's knocked off. Everyone goes by him, and then Gavin Yates goes right back after Anderson. Powell locked up with Asselineau. All penalty is going to be on Anderson with 14:48 left to go in the third, and then his helmet was knocked off. It's going to be a Biggie Tire power play as Anderson skates over to the penalty box. Boy, he was coming in for a massive hit. Yates did a good job to dodge it as best he could, but we'll take a break. It's a power play for Binghamton coming up when we return. Big moment, chance to get within one. Down 5-3 on your home for Black Bears Hockey, Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton. New hockey team. 14:48 to go in the third period. Rob Lapolis back inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. As the Black Bears, a Big E tire power play coming up. Corey Anderson in the penalty box. Black Bears now have e-gift cards available, and they make the perfect gift no matter what time of the year. It's fast, convenient. You choose the amount you want, the look of the card, and you can have it sent via email. Get an e-gift card by visiting BinghamtonBlackBears.com. Jurich at the point over to Powell. Binghamton, big moment here. They can get within one with a power play strike. Powell from the point, down to Yates. Vanderweel, and it's kept in. Vanderweel keeps it in. Sherman in front of the net, given up, and then a good bounce. And now the Black Bears got to get back. It's a shorthanded two-on-one. Ogic shooting, save made by Liskowitz. And a whistle with 14:21 to go in the third. Just what the Black Bears did not want to happen. An odd man rush, but great goaltending saves the day. Jurich back for Kyle Powell behind the net. He'll let Yates take over. Gavin Yates on the breakout. Skates it out to the blue line. Yates down the left wing side. In behind the net. Wraparound chance stopped. Now Vanderweel jams away. His helmet's ripped off at the side of the crease. And everyone settles down. 1:11 to go in the Big E tire power play. 13:59 left in the third. Ivashkin comes on the ice. Susie coming on for Ivashkin, Jurich, and Newberg. So Sherman and Vanderweel come off. Newberg will take the face off. Ivashkin to the right, Yates to the left, Jurich, Powell up top. Jurich, one-timer blocked. And off the boards all the way down the ice. 13 minutes, 45 seconds left to go, third period. Bad pass, and now the Black Bears got to take it back over, and Ivashkin does that. Nikita Ivashkin, top of the circle, shooting high. Puck comes free to the top of the crease. Still loose. Shot is deflected off the top of the glass. They can't get it out. Powell keeps the puck in. A foot from the blue line. Over to the left side for Jurich. Jurich, cross ice. Newberg, down low. Ivashkin. Ivashkin. Newberg in front of the net. It gets through to Jurich. Jurich, right side. Yates. Yates, front of the net. Tipped wide. Black Bears got to try to get back and keep this inside the zone. Newberg does it. Ivashkin behind the net. Still free. Outside the trapezoid. Gavin Yates backhanded all the way down. 5 seconds to go already. That's going to do it for the power play. Liskowitz to Jurich. Cross ice. It gets by Becker. This will be an icing. Man, a whistle with 12:43 left to go in the third. Sign up now to receive special offers, news, and see what's happening at upcoming Black Bears home games by joining the email club for free. Just head to BinghamtonBlackBears.com, click Join the Email Club to sign up. Back to the point, Matthew Wallar rips a shot wide of the net. Tyler Pekarski. Pekarski, good connect onto the backhand of Gavin Abbott. Abbott, left wing circle, cycles down for Gino D'Angelo, right back for, intended for Abbott, and then the puck is played onto the Danbury bench. That'll be an offensive zone faceoff. Sherman on the faceoff, Jurich to the left. Up top, good pass, Jurich overskated it just a little bit, gets possession back, knocks the puck in down low, and now this will go all the way down the ice, and it'll be another icing with 12:07 left to go in the third. 43 shots on net. Sherman, Jurich, Yates up front. Piekarski with Wallar on the point. Yates below the goal line. Jurich gets the puck and blocked by Frankie McClendon. Intercepted. Good pressure by the Black Bears here to start the third. Sherman misses the net. Piekarski gets to the puck first. Jurich below the goal line. And cleared up to Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov down the right boards. Ran out of gas. That line was out there for quite some time. Jurich tried to knock it down at center. To the right side, stepping up was Boilar. Two on one, knocked out of midair. And Boilar stepped up inside the neutral zone. And that was a two on one. Ivashkin with Jurich. Drops it back for Ivashkin, shooting, and a glove save. In and out of the glove of Frankie McClendon. Up to the right point. Blast by Merkel, glove save made. 11-11 left to go in the third period. Don't forget the Black Bears are giving away a free Skybox night. All you have to do is text Black Bears to 833-939-3323 and you're entered to win. That's Black Bears to 833-939-3323 and you could win a Skybox night at an upcoming Black Bears game. 11 minutes left to go in regulation. Binghamton down by two. It's 5-3 Danbury. Ivashkin back for Powell below the goal line. Long feed. Abbott, breakaway. Save made. Frankie McClendon stopping Gavin Abbott. Great luck by Powell from behind the net. Kept in by Newberg. Newberg, Abbott, backhand, save again. Danbury not happy. Anderson gave Gavin Abbott a little push right in front of the goalie. A little bit of contact was made, not much. And a little dust up after the play. Everybody calms down with 10:28 to go in the third period. What a chance for Gavin Abbott. Trying to go five hole. McClendon gets that right leg pad down though. Newberg on the faceoff. Abbott to the left, Ivashkin to the right. Now backhanded in below the goal line and up to Kuznetsov. Kept in by Newberg. Down low to Nikita Ivashkin. And now Kuznetsov takes over. Ahead through center ice. Good cutback by Anderson shooting, and it's blocked by Colin Fitzgerald. Back over to Corey Anderson. His second attempt is also blocked. 10 minutes to go, third period, 5-3 Danbury lead. Colin Fitzgerald around Dmitry Deniluk. Now Ivashkin, oh, that puck rolled off the end of his stick. He had to get rid of that quickly. Colin Fitzgerald right along the wall. Puck comes free, high slot, shot, skipper, and that's a right leg pad save by Liskowitz. Went off a Black Bear in front of the net. Good save. 9:30 left to go in the third period. Dumped in behind Colin Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald pins the puck up against the wall. It goes up in the air. That hit the net. And play continues. The puck goes off the net. No one saw it. Binghamton able to get the puck out of the zone though, and it's Jurich right side. Jurich looking for Sherman as he cut across. And now turnover, and Sherman takes down O'Reilly, and play continues. Danbury wanted a penalty, not going to get it though. Good play by Gavin Yates. Yates, Powell. Powell shooting. He misses high. Matthew Ballard, their shot by Merkel. Still loose. Jurich jams at it. How did that stay out of the net? A pile of players on the side of the crease. Wow, Jurich was hammering away at that puck on the side of the net. How did McClendon keep that out of the net? What a save. We'll step aside. 8:38 to go in the third period. Binghamton down by a pair. We're back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey. Fox Sports, 1430 Binghamton. And that's why every Saturday is a Little Venice Family 4-Pack Night. Get four tickets and a $25 Little Venice gift card for just $44. Visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com. 8:25 remaining in the third period. Garrett Gallagher shot. He was looking for a tip on the side of the net. Couldn't get it. And Jurich will move the puck off the glass and out to center. 8:14 remaining in the third. Matthew Ballard. Tyler Piekarski back to Ballard. Now Jurich, Corey Anderson. Piekarski lost the puck in his skates, finally gets it back. And then he will go off the glass. Icing waved off, Sherman and Daniluk shoulder to shoulder. Garrett Gallagher up the left wing side. Out to center, picked off by Powell. He lost it. Corey Anderson. Anderson, Kuznetsov, big block. And the Black Bears had a rush the other way. MJ Merkel was unable to get up after blocking the shot, so the whistle blows with 7:34 to go in the third. Hey, keep it here after the game for the La Quinta Inn and Suites postgame show. We'll have highlights courtesy of the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club, the Wise Market, three stars of the game. And in addition to that, the CryoWorks play of the game. So keep it here. After this one comes to a close for the La Quinta Inn & Suites postgame show. 7.5 minutes remaining in regulation. Liskowitz stops the puck. There's 7:26 left to go. Only game in the FPHL tonight. More action coming up tomorrow. A 3-3 Thursday, Friday, and Saturday for Binghamton. You don't see that every day. A lot of Sunday games coming up now until the end of the season, especially in March and April. So a busy couple of months to finish out everything. Obviously, once the Super Bowl ends and once football is over, all those Sunday games start popping up. Ivoshkin interfered with along the wall. Play continues. He throws his arms up to the official. And off the glass, down the ice, Tyler Becker. Becker in a foot race. Centered in front through everyone, and now Ivashkin 3-on-2. He's got Powell and Becker. Ivashkin is in, still with it, shooting, and did not pass, just elected to shoot. It was defended well. .639 to go in the third period. Offensive zone face-off, left wing circle. Newberg, Abbott, Ivashkin, Wallar, Pekarski. Gallagher. Now Gavin Abbott. Good bounce, and Danbury will take over. Ojik down the right side. Boilard. Ojik, what a save in front of the net. Kodiak White Duck now, top of the left wing circle. Danbury, some great chances here on this shift. Shot, save made. Black Bears try to clear, can't. Held in at the left point. 6:07 to go in the third period. Good play by Ivashkin now for Pekarski. And he dumps the puck in wide of the net. Gavin Abbott below the goal line. Abbott with some forecheck pressure. Tough bounce against, and White Duck goes off the boards out to center. Pekarski, left side, Vanderweel. He lost the puck, and now Powell. Kyle Powell. Left side for MJ Merkel back on the ice. Merkel run into in front of the Danbury bench. 5:25 now to go in the third. D'Angelo and Vanderweel in on the forecheck. It was right up in the air. Vanderweel goes down to the ice along with Daniluk. Now the shot tipped. Oh, that was close. Merkel. MJ Merkel a shot, no one in front of the net. Easy glove save for McClendon with 5:03 to go in the third. Shots are 48-31. Offensive zone faceoff inside the left wing circle. Binghamton needing a couple here. And this will be an icing. Or will it? Nope. As Liskowitz forced to cover, and we'll take a break. 4:54 to go. Third period. Danbury a 5-3 lead. Back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey. Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Drop the puck to the left. Of Owen Liskowitz. 4:50 to go, third period. And the Black Bears get a couple of late ones here. Matthew Wallar. Intercepted. Shot, save Liskowitz. Puck to his right. Backhanded to the front of the net, and Gavin Yates rolls the puck down, and icing is called against Binghamton. 4:27 now to go in the third. The hat tricks are one shot away from hitting the 50-shot mark.
side of the net. He's battling his Boilard in front of the crease. Puck comes out to center. Yates with a hit on Bryce French. Matthew Boilard. He'll go cross ice. Stepping up is Becker to kick the puck out of the zone. Becker now playing defense. He was a forward to start the game. Ogic hit by Boilard. Now Sherman, good pass to Yates, got under his stick blade. And Becker tried to knock the puck out of the air, taken by Adamo Asselin. To Jurich. Jurich right on the goal line. He'll skate in front of the crease, now to the hash marks. Goes back to the right side, Powell. We'll see who covers at the point. MJ Merkel, now Powell behind the net. Powell way up in the air. And stepping up was Yates with a hit on Anderson. Josh Newberg, low shot, stick save made. Back up Gino D'Angelo, save made. Now D'Angelo again, bottom of the right wing circle, has the puck on the backhand. D'Angelo for a shot, and Anderson knocks the puck down and then clears it down the ice. It'll be an icing with 3:04 to go in the third period. Binghamton will utilize a timeout. No, it'll be Danbury calling timeout with 3 minutes and 4 seconds to go in the third. Down by two. We'll see if Liskowitz stays on the bench or will they keep him out for a little bit longer. The faceoff is in the offensive zone. 3:04. Maybe just a little bit too early to pull the goalie. But if the Black Bears can win the faceoff in the offensive zone, maybe get a little possession, don't be surprised if you see Liskowitz going to the bench. Off in the offensive zone. Right wing circle, the net is empty. So Liskowitz is on the bench. The Black Bears, a 6-on-5. Jurich, Newberg, Yates, Ivashkin, Powell, Merkel. 6-on-5. Powell from the point, right side, Newberg. Low shot on net. That's blocked. And just wide. It'll be an icing with 2:53 to go in the third period. Well, again, we hope to see you back out here tomorrow night. Koozie giveaway to the first 1,500 fans presented by Excite Motorsports. And it's the final game that the Black Bears are here until February 19th. Gavin Yates. Yates, front of the net. Puck still free. Side of the crease. Cleared up. Not out. Kept in by MJ Merkel. Merkel inside the left wing circle. He lost the puck. Out to center ice is Kuznetsov. Kuznetsov scores. Merkel lost the puck inside the offensive zone. Kuznetsov comes all the way back down, and that'll seal it. 2:31 to go in the third, and the crowd filing out. Tomorrow is a huge game. You can't lose back-to-back at home.
Dmitry Kuznetsov, time of the goal, 17:29. Kuznetsov unassisted, time of the goal, 17:29.
2:15 left to go, third period. Save made by Liskowitz. Newberg to Powell. Powell up the right wing side, Ivashkin. Ivashkin over the blue line, weaving,
in and out of traffic, loses an edge behind the net. 1:55 to go in the third. 3-on-2. Lopez, low shot and a left leg pad save made by Liskowitz, and now Gavin Abbott. Abbott to Powell, 1:42 to go. Powell, Ivashkin, back to Powell, back to Ivashkin, still free, and it's covered up and squirts out on the right side. Great heads-up play by Garrett Gallagher. Locates the puck, goes all the way down the ice with it. Ivashkin to Newberg, back to Ivashkin. Ivashkin, D'Angelo! He tried to pull the puck back across to go to his backhand. It slid off the end of his blade, and the save was made by McClendon. 2-on-1 the other way. Backhand, left leg pad save, Liskowitz. 65 seconds to go in the third period. Up the right wing side, Colin Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald in, down to the ice he goes. Takes out McClendon as well, but play continues. 50 seconds to go in the third period. The win streak at home going to come to a close pending an epic collapse by Danbury. And now Colin Fitzgerald slowly skates in. Ivashkin to the net. Save made with 32 seconds left to go in the third period. Akita in and Sweets post-game show coming up. Juric. Shot deflected wide of the net. It is a 6-3 lead for Danbury. And shot misses high. 19 seconds to go. Ivashkin. High shot off the glass. 10 seconds left. Danbury going to get some revenge here over the Black Bears after the overtime loss. They come into Binghamton trailing 2-0 and come away with a 6-3 victory. We'll take a break. When we return, we'll kick off tonight's La Quinta Inn and Suites post-game show. Your final score in Binghamton, Danbury 6, Binghamton 3. Back right after this on your home for Black Bears hockey, Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Huh.